It's Sunday. Hey, hi. Welcome to Trendy Circalactica. I'm Jenny, your hostess with the mostest for Sunday. And I hope you guys are having a fantastic weekend. I'm having a pretty good one. Pretty nice. I've had some really good things happen for me. And my friend Cowboy Bob is having some fantastic things happen for him this weekend as well. Everything's been pretty good. A little sad, though, a little bit. I just found out one of my favorite actors died. His name was Ernest Borgnine, and most of y'all that are younger than me may know him as the voice of Mermaid Man in SpongeBob SquarePants. To me, I knew him as that really cool cab driver in Escape from New York. He was on Airwolf. He just pretty much was this actor, like, I'll watch shitty movies that I know I won't enjoy at all, just knowing that Ernest Borgnine played a little small role, so I'm a little sad over that, but other than that, it's been a really great weekend for me and everything, and without further ado, let's start this week's topic. It's one I chose, and it goes a little something like this. What do you consider to be the biggest obstacle in your transition? And I picked that because, you know, transition has a lot of obstacles and everything, and you know, they're all easy. I mean, you can, they're all obstacles that you can overcome and everything, but I thought I would ask, do you believe will be your hardest obstacle? And bear in mind, this has changed for me a few times. Originally, it was to come out to my friends and family, and I was really scared about that and everything. And it was hard. It was pretty hard. It was pretty scary during the moment, and it wound up, though, not being as bad as I thought. And I'm really thankful for that. So I guess for me right now, my biggest obstacle that I foresee coming is coming up for the cash for SRS and feminine facial surgery, because I mean, there's so much money. I mean, it costs more than it costs almost the price of a luxury car to get all this done. And how do I plan on overcoming that obstacle? Would be, well, I'm going to marry somebody rich and win the lotto, because I'm deep-rooted in reality. No. I'm not really sure how I'm going to overcome it. Definitely, because things are going a little better for me, and things are getting more and more stable in my life. For those of you that have watched my videos and followed me on Tranny Star have known, I've had a rough year last year, so thankfully things are steadily getting better. Slowly, but steady. And I guess when I start working a better job and or start working flat, which is coming very soon, I'm gonna set aside a part of my check each week to my surgery fund and everything, and hopefully, you know, when the time comes for me to get to that point in the road with surgeries and stuff like that, because I got a long way. I still have to restart transition and basically, you know, I gotta get rid of these facial hairs that I can't stand, and you know, slowly get back to going full time, which I can't wait for, because, you know, I was so happy being full time. But as big of an obstacle as that is, it's definitely, for me, is going to be getting the cash for the surgeries, which I definitely want. I want more than anything. But I have faith. I have faith that I will overcome this. And that's my suggestion to all of you out there. Whatever your obstacle is, to have faith. You have to be positive, and you have to have faith that it's going to get better. You don't want to stay, you know, deep-rooted in despair because the obstacle's so hard to overcome. Because, sweeties, a lot of people out there have overcome even bigger obstacles out there. And, I mean, just history's full of people that overcame impossible obstacles. And if they can do it, I can do it. And if a fuck up like me can do it, I know that all y'all are out there can overcome it as well. And I, as usual, I put forth the question to y'all, what do you think is going to be your biggest obstacle in transition, and how do you think you're going to overcome it? I mean, what are your plans to overcome it? Because, you know, it is important to have a plan set, you know, definitely. Anything that's worth achieving is worth having plans for and planning ahead, and I'd like to hear from all y'all. But this wasn't the only question I had. I had a light question too, a lighthearted question, which is, what is the best movie you've seen this summer? And for me, was the movie Battleship, because Battleship is based on the game Battleship, and which is based on sea warfare, and they could have done the cliche way and actually made a sea warfare movie about it, but no. They did the smart thing. They made a movie that was about almost nothing to do with the game, which is, of course, alien invasion, which, and again, I guess, you know, if you're on enough, you know, LSD, I guess you could look at the game and think it's, and come up with alien invasion. I mean, yeah. I'm probably just not that deep thinker, because I never thought that, but, you know, that movie just... It took so many daring risks. Like, you know, they could have, you know, done something like planned ahead and had a great cast and had a great, you know, actually put effort in writing a good script. But no, not the makers of Battleship. No, they went above and beyond and decided to put out a really shitty script with even worse acting in it. And I really respect that. No, I'm fucking lying. That was an awful, awful, awful fucking movie. I mean, this movie's bad and it's boring. And no offense if y'all loved it. You know, if you watched it and you liked it, I mean, God bless. I mean, because I like certain movies that nobody else likes. I like basketball, and nobody likes basketball but me. I'm just poor guys in that too. The best movie I've seen this summer was The Avengers. That to me impressed me so much. I kind of had a little faith that it was going to be big. It was going to be a good movie because it was written by my favorite writer director, Joss Whedon, which most of y'all know I'm a huge Whedon fan. I love everything he did except for Alien Resurrection. He wrote the script for that, and I don't know. Maybe he was in a coma when he wrote it. I don't know. I don't know what he was doing there. But besides that, Whedon does nothing, writes nothing that isn't just dripped with brilliance. And so I kind of knew that it was going to be good. And another reason I knew it was going to be good is ever since Marvel has been making their own movies, starting with Iron Man, their movies have been fantastic. I've loved Iron Man, Iron Man 2. I even liked Incredible Hulk, which... There's going to be some of y'all out there that's going to go, what, that one with Ed Norton? That sucked. And to me, though, I like that movie. That's how a Hulk movie should be. But Thor, Captain America, they all were good. And this was better. God, most of y'all have already heard. If you haven't seen it already, you've at least heard from people that have seen it how awesome it is. Like, I don't think I've read one bad review of this movie. I mean, it had everything. It had the Mighty Marvel feel to it all, and it had humor. It had great character, great action. I mean, you know, it had surprises in it. The Hulk was badass in it. And, I mean, I think everybody really went above and beyond. That was just my favorite movie this summer. It's actually my favorite superhero movie of all time now. It's just wonderful. I can't wait for it to come out on DVD. It's just wonderful. I had a great time. It's a great flick. If you haven't seen it, oh, definitely go see it. Even if you hate superhero movies, go see this movie, because because I know people that don't like superhero movies that are loving the shit out of that movie because it's awesome. But yeah. So what's your favorite movie this summer? I'd like to hear from all y'all and everything, because Lord knows I like to see a good movie, and y'all probably might have seen one I haven't seen yet. So I always like suggestions. But that's all for me this week. I love y'all very much. Thank you for continuing to watch these videos on Sunday and everything. And I love y'all very much. Y'all are wonderful, fantastic people. Every one of y'all are important to the world, and each one of y'all make this world a little brighter, and I just feel so blessed to be in the same world as y'all. I love y'all, and I'll see y'all next week. Tune in tomorrow and each and every day this week for another fantastic episode of Tranny Star, where we'll have another great host and hostess. Before I forget, most of y'all won't know what I'm talking about, but I did want to give a shout out to our very own Bryce. She's come out to some people on Facebook, and she's been getting fantastic, responses from what I'm seeing, and it makes me very happy to see that. And I have I already like her anyway. She makes great videos. Everybody on Tranny Star, we have a very strong lineup right now, and Bryce makes it a little better, but congrats, Bryce. I'm just so happy for you, and I'm so proud of you, and I respect you so much for what you did this week. Anywho, I'll see y'all next week. I love y'all very much, and until then, transmission out.